Really got so it. Well, she's here in the studio with us on the Urban Jazz Experience, ready to share her jazz journey with us. And this is how it begins.
Hashtag MyJJ on Metro FM.
Church, yes, it was in church when I really knew, actually, this is it, you know, this is
I'm loving what I'm hearing. And also, you know when you're told by somebody else that you can sing?
Yeah.
Because you didn't know. Mm. You know, we were just playing around. We're just kids and we're bored. And we went to this woman's house, was one of the church members. Mm. Her name is Sweetness Gwabe. And we were
still there. You still remember?
I remember that woman. I love that woman with all of my heart. Mm. She brought out a whole lot out of me. I remember how she used to yell at me. She would not yell at anybody but me in the church choir. And she always believed that I've got something and she will bring it out, you know. And I remember once she told me to, okay, now you know the song and stop singing the notes and start getting into the music. And I remember looking at the door thinking I'm going to walk out because I've had it. This woman is just always on my case. I never do anything right. And also, you know, you're also starting to think, because everyone tells you you're amazing, and you're starting to think, but I'm amazing. Can this woman hear I'm amazing? Why is she always shouting?
And you know, it was tough love.
Exactly. And I remember looking at the door thinking, this is it. I'm not getting paid, for starters. I still got school to go to, and I don't live at this woman's house. Why is she treating me like this? I'm going to go to my mother's house, and this woman must leave me alone. And I looked at the door, wanted to walk out. And I'm glad I didn't walk out that day, because it would have destroyed everything I've learned thereafter.
Wow.
And for me, that was a very defining moment. That's why I don't forget her, because she cracked something in me and broke something in me and built something in me at the same time that I can't really get.
But that was over. That was church.
That was church.
And then you started singing what?
And then I was very fortunate to be called in by Sweetwater Manzimtoti, you know, to come and sing in a gospel choir, sort of a gospel group, a small gospel group to Tuzinamba back in those days in Felicia Marion.
Mm.
And that actually opened the doors to the Market Theatre in 93. And getting into the Market Theatre for the first time, singing in the theatre at the age of 19.
I will.
Don't start counting, because please, I don't want people.
We won't say, the year.
My age. But anyway, I look fabulous for my age, so I don't mind saying.
You did say you're awesome.
Oh yes, exactly.
Yeah.
So you know, the Market Theatre sort of got me introduced into the theatre work, into the professional world, like the seriously professional world, where you're standing on stage with these amazing singers, because there was like Jennifer Ferguson, Felicia Marion, Michelle Maxwell, Mamu Sophie Mkina, that's when I first met her, and the things they said to me, they spoke so much brilliance, and I was the youngest, and for me, I felt cradled and introduced into something massive by just brilliant artists, that in such a way that's why nobody actually knows how old I am, because I've always been on stage with the eldest of the people.
and also being introduced to theater, maybe that's why you're very theatrical.
Yeah.
Justin Jill, where in Nigeria?
I'm big, because in theater you need to be very big.
Yeah. And you become big on stage. Let's talk about this next song, because this is she's my favorite female jazz vocalist. And I keep wanting someone to overtake her. I'm waiting for someone to overtake her, and, you know, so that she becomes second and not first. But you tell me about Rochelle Farrell.
It's okay. She's the first to a whole lot of us. I walked into a record bar in France in 96. I call it a record bar because that's what it was called back then. Back then, in 96. Mm. And that was one of my first trips overseas. You know, I was very fortunate. I replaced Umama Sibongile on some projects. I went in there into that record bar. They were blasting the CD, first instrument in particular.
Yes.
I couldn't believe my ears. Yeah. I took my pedium and I bought the CD. And you know, those days, 159 francs was a lot of money to spend on music.
Mm.
And I thought, you know, I just found a person that stirs something in me.
Mm.
And the freedom of it, the beauty of it, the grandeur, the whole expression, the madness
it
of
is
it
incredible.
Just went for me, you know.
And it's funny how I also heard her for the first time when I was in France.
Ah.
And I was introduced to her by a friend I had met in France.
Uh-huh.
And he said, took the album and said, listen, this is for you. Listen to this woman.
Yeah.
I was also like gobsmacked. Like, my goodness.
Yeah. And I was just excited. I said, I want to sing like this too. I want to be mad. I want to do this. And thank you,
a whole lot of thank you to her for telling me it's okay to sing like that. Because, you know, when you're young, you're trying to find your sound, you're trying to find things, and someone comes and says, no, you can just be anything you
Absolutely.
Want.
Absolutely, just like her.
Yeah.
Why is she not playing now? What's wrong with her? No, you just keep talking. I'm going to sort this
out. Okay. You need to sort that out. Because somebody's got to hear that.
Your favorite Rochelle Ferré of music?
You sent me the track you sent me from the CD First Instrument, and everything else that she's done thereafter, you know, even her individuality recording, you know, the brilliance of it. And the fact that she's just a risk taker, I think she's a singer worth listening to and a singer worth learning a whole lot from.
And yes, I like the way she moves her mouth when she makes the sound.
Yeah.
Only place.
Have you voted for your favorite SABC3 Viewer's Choice Mrs. SA finalist? Want to know who the winner of the SABC3 Viewer's Choice will be and who takes the next Mrs. SA Crown of Virtue? Then don't miss the crowning ceremony on Sunday, 19 November 2017 at 6 p.m. Only on SABC3. The stage is yours.
Police have been running battles with the residency in Kibera, of course being a NASA stronghold, and people really heeding the call from Raila Odinga, and some has themed these elections that it is Uhuru versus Uhuru.
You are only seconds away from the latest story. Hashtag SABC News. My First is a brand new thrilling SABC One reality series which seeks to follow first-timers in all areas of life through their emotional yet intriguing journeys. We are looking for brand new compelling stories from young men and women who want to share their emotional and engaging journey of their very first experience with us. Email us on info@myfirst.org.za or find us on Facebook or write to us on My First PO Box 3164 North Riding 2162.
East London, we've got you covered. 107.7 FM. It's where you're at. My jazz journey with no tempo. With no tempo on Metro FM.
Bésame.
The sensitivity of the music. classic. She catches it, you know. And when she needs to swing, she swings. But when she's doing a jazz ballad, it's the most beautiful thing. It's like you're ready to fall in love. You're ready to roll on the hay, whatever you want to do. That's Natalie Cole for you.
What have you learned from many of these female jazz singers that you admire and that have inspired you? What are the things that you've adopted in when you perform and when you sing?
I think I've learned to just be free and be crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And to love and to just adore the music.
Mm-hmm.
And their power and how they express themselves and their non-apologetic take of who they are and how they want to present themselves as singers, for me it's just too powerful. And I always feel that when you're learning from other people, it's not a matter of trying to mimic them. It's about you finding your identity, you know, within their journeys. Because abahambe phambikwakho, those that have come before you, they have tasted and they've laid a foundation. And we all build on that foundation because we much, you know, musically or whichever other way, connected much more than we can ever know.
True.
So there's a lot to take from somebody else, but the most important thing is that it must be able to bring out the truth about you.
Mm.
And that's why I don't have a specific singer that I listen to. I listen to everyone. And that for me helps, you know, break free whatever is in me.
And helps you to stay your authentic you.
Exactly.
when you perform. So Gloria, where's the music? Watula Jena.
I'm not as quiet as you think,
okay? Okay, where's the music? I don't have a new album.
Yes, I know, don't worry. I'm working on it. You know when I've been using other sort of kind of mediums to bring the music out there.
What have you been doing?
I've been writing a song a minute a day. I've got a thing called a song a minute a day.
Okay.
I write a song every day and I post it on social media. That has been my crazy thing that I've been doing. I believe that there's a song in me every morning. So I write.
So how do you post it on social media? What do you do?
I play the guitar and I post it on social media.
Like,
as simple as that.
On Facebook, on Twitter?
On Facebook and on Twitter and on Instagram.
So
and
we can find the full album there because there are many songs.
There's already 69 songs there.
What?
There's already 69 songs there. You know what I thought? It's like we're always trying to use the you know, sort of the traditional ways of getting music out there.
Mm.
And at the same time, there's a lot of musicians who have passed on with there are a whole lot of music that has never been heard by people.
Yeah.
And I said, I'm not going anywhere with any of this music. I'm going to leave it here.
Okay.
And I'm going to use whatever I have, you know, as a way of mobilizing the music and keeping it alive. And just for people to know that I'm not just a pretty face. I also write. I write music and love writing
music. What have you been writing about?
I've been writing about love. I've been writing about love, a whole lot of love. And I've been writing about, you know, daily issues,
okay,
people and how people relate to each other and with each other. And as I say, there's 69 that's on there, but there's a whole lot that's
still. So when are we getting some of those on an album or something that we can get at once instead of going to
yes,
the social media?
I'm going to be releasing two singles in December.
Okay.
So I want some of that music to start now sort of materializing, becoming full songs.
Okay, let's tell people where to go on social media to find to listen to those 69 songs so that maybe they can recommend to you which ones should
exactly
be on the album.
Exactly, that's the whole idea. Instagram is Gloria Bosman, Twitter is Gloria Bosman. I use my name on everything. So
okay.
I don't try and be fancy.
you want to be easily found.
Yeah, easily found. Actually, I was cheeky enough to call myself I Am Music on Twitter.
I forgot that.
Yes, I call myself I Am Music on Twitter. And then on Facebook, it's Gloria Bosman. And the music is there. Just go, sample it, listen.
I will be doing this at the end of the show. Watch me.
I'll be
listening to that music.
Thank you.
Okay, let's talk about this last song. And we have
Of course, an inspiration for many jazz female vocalists. Miss Ella Fitzgerald.
Oh, yeah. Duh. Mama Ella. Mm. My dad used to call her Mama Ella. Mm. My dad actually introduced me to her when I was 11. You know, when you like subconsciously learning stuff and you're not even aware that you...
Yeah, actually.
He would play my cassette and, you know, rewind it and just go like, this is the queen of bebop, you know? But he didn't even know that I will sing someday or even... get to love jazz this much.
Wow.
And he would play me this Ella Fitzgerald and I would listen and go like, whoa, there's a whole lot of madness and so much notes, this woman though, you know, and get so excited. And growing up and listening to that and getting a taste of that music later in my life when I can buy my own CDs, you know, the excitement of it, Ella Fitzgerald.
So in your CD collection, do you have these women?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Are there no men there in your collection?
But there is. I mean, there's Chris Botti, which I learned from you. Love Chris Botti.
Yeah, okay.
There is, you know, then when you're speaking of singers, then you'd have your Al Jarreau. Learned so much from Al Jarreau. And
he's also got his another technique. In
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Can you imagine some of these? We're talking about people who've passed on.
Yes. Yes,
except for Miss Diane Reeves and
Rachel Farrell.
May God keep them a little longer for us. Don't
worry. When they're done doing what they were here to do, then we will wave them goodbye in peace.
Gloria, I could talk to you forever, but I've got to let you go.
I don't want to go.
I know. I don't want you to go either. But thank you so much. We're looking forward to those two singles that are coming out in December. Please follow Gloria Bosman at @iammusic@GloriaBosman. And playing out with Ella Fitzgerald, I've Got You Under My Skin is the track that you've chosen.
Yeah.
Are you going to sing with her or are you going to leave her to do her thing?
I better sing with her.
Okay.
Sweet dream. I've got you under my skin. I have got you deep in the heart of me. So deep, yes, in, deep in my heart, you're really a part of me. I have got you under my skin.
Yeah, said if I should have been come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of the warning voice that comes in my every piece of me comes in my ear. Don't you know, you're a fool, never can win. Use your mentality, we you got your reality. Cause each time I do, it's just a good of you. If you saw people rubbing in, I got ya. Yeah. What's it up?
As Gloria Bosman, she certainly had us under her skin, or should we say we had her under her skin. I'm not sure which it is. It is the Urban Jazz Experience on Metro FM. Certainly hope you enjoyed that jazz journey, which was rather long. We are going to go into our jazz lounge mix. We're also going to get into, what is it? Yes,